My name's Ed Bollom and I'm the head gardener at Gordon Castle Walled Garden. And over the next few months, we're going to create a series of step-by-step guides to productive gardening. We have an 8-acre wall garden here at Gordon Castle, and we grow herbs, fruit and vegetables, cut flowers, all sorts of different things. And we thought it would be quite handy for you to get some of our tips of the trade to give you better results in your garden. And we thought, what better place to start than seed sowing? So our first tip is to use specialised seed compost. You can use multi-purpose, but you'll get much better results if you use a specific seed compost. And the reason being, it has a much finer, more free-draining composition, which means you're less likely to get damping off, and also it has lower nutrients and you'll get better quality seedlings. So first thing to do is break it up, get it to a nice fine texture, and then fill up your seed tray to about two-thirds its depth. We tend to use these half-size seed trays because it's more than enough room to get up to 50 plants from a seed tray like this, depending on the variety that you're growing. You can use the bigger seed trays, but to be honest, it's just a waste of compost and a waste of space for us. So you're much better off with little seed trays, I think. Firm it down once you've filled it up. We use these tampers just to make it easy. You can just use your hand, but you'll get more even results with a purpose-built tamper. Don't firm it too hard because you don't want to squash all the air out of it, but it is good to have it firm because you're less likely to get water logging. And then what we have here is some ammi. These go into our cut flower beds. We grow all sorts of different shapes and sizes of seeds, but most of the things we grow we can sow into a seed tray, and we cover with about a centimetre of soil. The rule of thumb is to cover it with two or three times the size of the seed. So you plant them at two or three times the depth of the seed, but that's not a hard and fast rule. So I tend to just pour them out into my hand and then take a pinch and try and sprinkle them as evenly as possible over the compost. It can be quite tricky to do, but if you take your time, you can get a fairly even spread. It doesn't look like many seeds, but there's probably 60 or 70 seeds here, and if you use a decent seed company, you should get 80 or 90% germination. So you just sprinkle them over. There we go. And the next thing, rather than just getting a handful of compost and spreading it over the top, try to use a sieve or a gardener's riddle. Quite a fine one is best. Fill it up and then gently shake it over the top. Don't bury them too far, so we're looking about, because they're quite small seeds, just under a centimetre, something like that. There we go. Clean up the edges. And then, most importantly of all, put in a label. You're much better off using a pencil to do your labelling because it's much more resilient to bright sunlight and to watering. We've tried all sorts of different types of marker pen and all sorts of things, and good old pencil works much better. And also, you can reuse your labels just by rubbing them out and use them again next year, so you're not wasting too much plastic. So we'll just put ammi on this one. And then the variety, Casablanca. And we just put the date down that we sowed it, so we have some sort of idea of when it should germinate. Most of our seeds tend to germinate within about 7 days. We're lucky we have heated greenhouses and a propagator, so that makes the whole process much easier. If you can afford to do that, you'll get much better results if you can put them in a propagator. Or a heat mat works very well. Failing that, a warm windowsill, preferably not a south-facing windowsill because bright lights will scorch your seedlings, and preferably not anywhere where you get extreme variations in temperature. So you don't want it somewhere drafty, you don't want it somewhere too hot, like above a radiator. But you will find if you don't have a propagator, it will take a little bit longer for your seeds to germinate. So I'll just put the date on. There we go. Pop it in. And the other thing that's quite important is it's much better if you can water these from below. So rather than getting a watering can, watering it from above, Get a small tray of water and sit your seed tray in it for about 10 to 15 minutes is normally long enough, and you can see the water slowly getting sucked up and you can see the change in colour of the compost. And it works much better because you're much less likely to disturb the seeds. And that's particularly important if you have very, very fine seeds that you need to sow on the surface and not cover with compost. If you water it with a watering can, you'll wash them all to the edge, and then they potentially will get buried and not germinate. So much better off watering them from below. And try and use warm water. We always keep our watering cans in the greenhouse to keep them warm, keep them full in the greenhouse. And we find we get better results, and when they've germinated and you've got tender young seedlings, you're much better off giving them more water rather than freezing cold water out of the tap. So that's it. It's fairly straightforward, fairly simple, and we'll move them across to the greenhouse.